So right now we are juggling an app on VR1. Vanguard V. We have Ocean Rift on GearVR. And I'm just going to show you something quickly on actually, let me show you TriDef Android 3D, which you probably haven't seen. Probably really should. So this would be Minecraft in 3D, in Android 3D. That we place into our GearVR. Now this is a 1080p phone, and straight away I can show you that, I can tell you that there is very little screen door or pixelation, no blur, and 3D is pretty impressive. For $2. Over here we have GearVR. Now I tap on the proximity sensor. Actually, why don't we get rid of this? So now we should get a better look. Okay. So now we're swimming with the fishes in Oculus VR with sharks and all sorts going on. Now, what you don't see here, because I'm filming through Google Glass, is you can see screen door right now. This is actually the best demo, I think, so far. But you must remember, these are demos. You're not actually going to do anything with this. It's not going to take over your life. It hasn't become the app, the killer app, that will launch virtual reality, with all due respect to the people who worked on it. I still think it's the best demo there is on GearVR. Like all Cellphone View Master devices, all three, you'll feel the size, you'll feel the 3D. The thing is, it's the tolerance of the device that really kills one of these devices straight away, and that's GearVR. You cannot use this device for the length of time you want to use this device. Firstly, because of the battery, there's no way to charge it because of the design. The insistence on launching apps through a walled garden means it's extremely limited in its scope, whereas this $2 bit of cardboard, which you can have any phone attached to, isn't limited. I mean, this is running TriDef 3D for Android, proper 3D for Android, and it works stunningly well on Google Cardboard in a Cellphone ViewMaster VR device, but you can't get that on this. Unless it goes through the App Store, the Oculus App Store. So this is not open VR. I mean, if the Zeiss is VR for everyone, including iOS fans and developers, then GearVR is VR for just one. And then, again, it's one unique device, your Note 4. I'm going to talk a little bit about the design of these HMDs and why usage tolerance is different. Now, this isn't a solid tray. The solid tray protects your phone. The back does not come off. It's still transparent. AR apps already are more advanced on this. The experience can change, so tomorrow that, what is it, 2K phone in there could be a 4K phone in there. And the most basic negative fact for GearVR is the way that it steams up and heats up, because this is seems to be like hermetically sealed. I'm sure there's a vent in there somewhere, but it's impossible to find. Now, if you look at GearVR 1 even, you should see vents at the top, vents at the bottom. And this foam is less insulating. Let me come to the optics. If you look here, these are the different optics. These are the Oculus designed optics. And they throw up screen door, visible pixels, blurry images, all the usual stuff you used to on the Rift. These optics are in a league of their own. These are the most comfortable optics on any Cellphone ViewMaster HMD. Sitting between them is your $2 cardboard dive optics, which are perfectly fine. Now, if you want a mission critical thing, your application, you need one of these. Firstly, because you can't actually really use this for anything, other than like I could make a YouTube video for it, but do I actually want to use it when I got this? Well, that's up to you. That's the brilliant thing about choice. We don't have to go with the Oculus, go with Samsung, we don't have to go with Zeiss. You find one that suits you and go with that. But having said that, once again, I'm looking at, and when I look at HMDs, what I really look at is, can I actually use them? I've been using them since the old HMZT series, and the problem with that was you couldn't actually use them. And what Mr. Carmack and Oculus have designed in this is another HMD you can't actually use for anything for the length of time that you'd want to use it. And that is the truth. And it used to be that people would say, and it makes me laugh, people would say, all virtual reality has nausea, all virtual reality head tracking has lag. And I know from experience that is rubbish, because there are devices that you can use that already have, sometimes that are just $2 worth, that you can use without any of those issues. So if you want open VR and you have any kind of mission critical thing, then I think the best, well, I know the best quality HMD, Cellphone ViewMaster HMD, is this little thing. So if you're the developer of Vanguard V, you don't have to go through a Samsung store or another walled garden or leap over another promotional fence hurdle. This is your app. It's out there. It's working right now. It's working on cardboard. It's working on this. And it here it's working for millions of people, literally. Here it's working for a couple of thousand people, and for the time being. So as a developer, you really got to get real. You might be spending thousands of man hours developing the awesome software that really will power, drive virtual reality. But if you're doing it for a device that no one can use longer than 20 minutes, or comes with a warning, that you shouldn't use, which I find quite interesting, anywhere near someone who has a pacemaker, that's quite fascinating, really. And it just goes to show you that great design doesn't have to be backed by billions of dollars. Or even if it is backed by billions of dollars, it doesn't have to cost $2. Or somewhere, people are sitting solving problems without all the hoopla and hype that it surrounds all these virtual reality headsets that most of us feed off on, really. Now, I'm going to do a more detailed review of this because I love some of the apps. I'd say the software for GearVR is more advanced than the hardware. The software is really waiting for the hardware to catch up, and that's the story of VR, really. We can create great experiences, but the presence that's generated, or could be generated, the potential of it, is failed at the moment by the design of devices like this. So you can hear a lot of hype about this. But these are probably those are people who have never gone near a virtual reality device other than this. Who actually sat down and thought, hey, what would happen if I really did watch a film other than to promote it on YouTube? So, I find all this stuff fascinating. What I really don't understand is how John Carmack managed to take a quad HD panel and still produce screen door to the level that exists in this, and then close off the design with this USB connector. So you can't charge this phablet, which has trouble running without being connected to a HMD for not too long. So now, to illustrate this, I could take my GearVR, and I have done, place it in Google Cardboard, sorry, my Galaxy Note 4, and place it in Google Cardboard, and again produce a VR image with less screen door and optical issues using this $2 worth of equipment. Now that's where you've really got to start thinking. If you're Samsung, or if you're Oculus, if you're Google, or you're Zeiss, basically. So I see this field is open. It's open to anyone. Anyone sitting there right now listening to this could make a better device than any of these devices right now. And that's really the truth about Cellphone View Master VR at the moment. So in summary, if you want a device you can use on iPhones, on Android phones, if you're developing as an iOS developer, then this is your thing. Google Cardboard could be your thing as well. If you're into VR promotion, then obviously Samsung Gear VR is your thing because you've probably been promoting it for the last year heavily. And you'll probably be promoting Gear VR 2, which promises to fix the problems in Gear VR 1 and Gear VR 3. If that sounds harsh, it's not really. As Mr. Carmack probably tell you, I can sound a lot harsher in criticism. But someone's got to say these things because we have an opportunity to bring virtual reality to the masses. And if we overhype it, then we basically are going to end it before it arrives again. And that's happened before, although people have short memories. So it is fascinating pushing these devices, working with these devices, but know their limits and know their strengths. Each one has their own strength. And the best thing to do is try them all out for yourself. And It sounds like a cliche, but don't believe the hype. So thanks for watching, and more to follow as I continue to explore how to mess with these things at the game beta.